Now this video that we are going to start is very important because it covers a very important topic, resolving the expressions that have multiple post or pre increment and decrement operators. Many students have doubt in this, so come, let's begin the topic. So let's discuss how we resolve the expression that have multiple pre and post increments in them. This is very important. Understand this with the help of these three examples very carefully. We will resolve this by using a rule, that is the 3P rule. The 3P rule states that first we will simplify the pre-increments. Suppose there are three pre-increments here, plus plus x, plus plus x, plus plus x. These are three pre-increment operations and this one is only one post-increment. So first step is simplify all the pre-increments. Then place the latest value that you obtained in the whole expression and then resolve the post increments. Let's consider the example. Suppose if x is equals to 10, then plus plus x is the pre-increment we will consider is first. It will make the value 11. Then this is also plus plus x. We already had got 11 value. So now here it will make 12. Now the latest value of x is 12, so we will place 12 in all the expressions. Here also we will make it 12, here also we place it 12, here also we place it 12. Then 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12 will give you result 48. Now the third step is post increment. This is one post increment and this is one post increment. Now resolve this. This x plus plus will make it 13 and this x plus plus will make it 14. That means in the memory x will have value of 14 for this first expression. If we write a statement, say c out x, after resolving this expression, then this c out x will result value 14. This is how multiple pre and post increments are treated. Consider this: x plus 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 x plus 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 x plus 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 x. Now first step is resolving the pre-increments. There is only one pre-increment, that is plus plus x. It will make 11. Then the second step is place the value in the whole expression. This is 11. This will also become 11. 11, 11. 11 plus 11 plus 11 plus 11. It will give 44. Now resolve the post. This post will make it 12, 13, 14. So here also x will have 14 in the memory. If we write c out x, it will display 14. Now here plus plus x plus 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 x plus 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 x plus x plus plus. 1, 2, 3. 3 pre-increment. So this will make 11. This will make 12. This will make 13. Now we have used all the pre-increments. Place the latest value. Latest value is 13. It will also become 13. It will also become 13. And here also we place 13. Then 13 plus 13 plus 13 plus 13 will give you 52. Now the latest value of x is 13. Then resolve the post. Post is this one only. So 13 will get 14. In the memory x will be 14. So I hope so. How to resolve the multiple pre and post increment operation expressions is clear to you. Now here is one exemplar program. We have to give the output. So let's see it. Int x is equals to 10. One variable is x and assign the value 10 and one is y. Y is having this value x plus 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 x plus 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 x plus x plus plus. See out. X is equals to will be printed as it is in the double quotes. Y is equal to will be printed as it is in the double quotes. And here values of X and Y will be printed, get CS. So let's solve it. In this expression, there are two pre-increments, this one and this one. Then X is equals to 10. Plus plus X will make it 11. And this plus plus X will make it 12. Now pre-increment we have resolved. The next step is place the latest value. Latest value is 12. So this 11 will also become 12. This will also become 12. And this will also become 12. Then 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12. The result will be 48. Here there are two post increments now. This one and this one. this will make the x value to be 13 and this will make the x value to be 14. So in the memory x will be 14. If I write cout x is equals to, this x value will be 14 and this y will be 48. This will make the memory's value to be printed. So I hope this example is also now clear to you. Now here is one more program. Int x is equals to 3. This time 3 is initialized to x and one variable is y. Y is having value plus plus x plus 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 x. And we have to give the outputs of y and x. So let's do it. There are two pre-increments, plus plus x and plus plus x. This will make the x value to be 4 and this will make the x value to be 5. Now we always place the latest updated value. Latest updated value is 5. So this 4 will also become 5 and 5 plus 5 will become 10. That means value of y will be 10 here. See out y is equals to 10 will be printed. And here x is equals to, here also x will become 5. X will be treated as 5 because there is no post increment that will change the value of x. Only this is the final value of x. I hope so this is also now clear to you. So after this discussion, I hope you can solve any of the expressions of post and pre increment that are having multiple expressions inside them. And I hope this is all is also clear to you. If you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section or just drop an email at the email address mentioned in the description of the video. To find our latest uploads and the playlist, please find on the screen. And if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe it also. Thank you.